Hello everyone, Randy here again. We're playing Farming Simulator 15 on Pleasant Valley Rivers on the RDL and multiplayer server, and joined by Vincent at the moment. And we've got the Freightliner, I believe. Yes, Freightliner with the truck here. And we're going to get a little paper, hopefully, and bring it down to National Gypsum. Still working on getting the drywall from for the various construction places we have going on. Drywall has definitely been a major slowdown on the server here. I don't know why, but maybe just the amount of stuff drywall takes. But yeah, definitely been a major slowdown here getting the drywall. Oh, you know what? I gotta be on the other side here. Resin is on the side with the tanks here and the paper. Oh, you know what? There's a truck here with maybe there's some paper in it already. Okay. See if I can maybe hook up to this. I don't know if this particular trailer will pull that one or not, but if it does. Nah, it's in the way, isn't it? Okay. Might have to get one of the other Volvo trucks up here. The AR trucks up here. See if I can get those out of the way. If this truck doesn't hook up anyway. Which I'm guessing it probably won't. We'll find out. Well, that's probably good then, because that means we got more paper than I thought we have. Oh, it does hook up. Wow, look at that, folks. I am surprised. Oh, you know what? Not much in there, though, is there? Oh, we're gonna be close enough for the trigger? No. That is one of the biggest complaints I have on Pleasant Valley Rivers here, folks. The triggers are just like so incredibly picky, it seems like. Am I seriously not? Oh, maybe if I select that, maybe that would help. Nope, still doesn't. Start filling. Oh, come on now. I know we have paper. Yeah, we do. We have 21,249 paper. At least according to that, anyway. I believe Vincent said he was gonna start working on some wood chipping there. We get this paper delivered. We'll see what's maybe we can give him a hand here. We'll get some wood chips into Cogent. Why is this not filling, though? I'm not sure. Okay, well, I just created a pallet there. That probably don't really want that. Yeah, by the way, for those of you wondering, how do you get pallets of various products? If you want a pallet, you just got to click on it here. I don't know if it does it for everything, but you can usually get the pallets. But yeah, come to think about it, I probably don't actually want that. At least with the trailer I currently have anyway. Okay, so why is that not loading paper? Let's try with the big truck here. Connect that. Oh, there we go. Now I can put paper. Don't know why that trailer wasn't holding paper, but that's weird. Okay, we'll see if we can get this little trailer hooked back up here. And we'll get this down to National Gypsum, which is out of paper. Apparently, must use a lot of paper for making drywall. I haven't really paid attention to how much is used for each item, but yeah, we've been burning through the wood chips, folks. And I mean burning through them. It's just ridiculous. I'd like to see a number on how many wood chips we've made so far. And that just for drywall, too, yet. It's like about every other time I'm on the server, I'm doing wood chips, or someone, pretty much somebody's always doing wood chips almost, it seems like. The Cogent really burns through the wood chips, get a little bit of paper, bring it down to National Gypsum, it burns through the paper. Just ridiculous, it seems like. But anyway, we are making progress. I have to check on the various locations that need drywall. I know Frito-Lay, I think that's the only thing it is waiting on is drywall. Probably the only thing PepsiCo is waiting on too is drywall. Whoa, hang on, what in the world? That was kind of weird. Not sure what happened there. I think our rear trailer there went a little nuts and started causing issues. Oh, by the way, for those of you wondering, we went past the orchards here. Oh, was it a couple episodes back, folks? We were having trouble with the blocks going into the orchards to build them. Turns out we did have to restart the server. Once we restarted the server, then the orchard did take the blocks. And we now have, the pair one here. That one is all set. And I don't remember, is this the plum one? The server needs to be restarted again, so we can get the final blocks. They're in there. It shows them there, but for some reason it's not working, so we just need to restart the server again, so it will take those blocks. What I've noticed, folks, and when you build these, at least on a multiplayer server, put the blocks in first. Okay, that was weird. Put the blocks in first. Let's walk back over here. Put the blocks in first. It will take the blocks then, and then you can put the rest in. It seems like if you put the blocks in later, it will not take the blocks, and you have to restart the server for some reason. So, as you can see, this one has the blocks. It just needs manure and cherries, apparently, at this point, to be finished being built. So, yeah, it's just a good tip there. Can I get to this one? I can, okay. Just a good tip there. Put your blocks in first, and then you shouldn't have any issues, I hope. What is the issue? Why are we not moving? Oh, my ping has gone through the roof. Okay. Yeah, we've been having some really hot weather where I live at the moment, folks, and I'm thinking our internet is just not liking this hot weather. The last couple days, my internet has just been absolute crap. Some really high ping numbers and really fluctuating badly, so there might be a few more Oklahoma series going on the next couple of days with this hot weather if this continues. I'm not sure if that's actually the cause or not, but like I said, it's been hot the last couple days, and the last couple of days my internet has just not been working too well. Okay, let's see what's here. Drop off some paper. Oh, back forward a little bit. Okay, that seems weird. Oh, wait a minute. It's got to be in my trailer yet. There we go. Okay. It emptied the rear trailer, not the front trailer. That's what happened. Yeah, folks, if we look at a National Gypsum here. So it's got paper now again. Oh, it's getting a little low on glue. We should probably bring some more glue. Probably got plenty of glue. Glue has not been an issue. Yeah, we currently have 144,000 liters of glue. It does need some resin, which also comes from the Cogent factory, by the way. So yeah, Cogent's been working like quadruple overtime making all the stuff for this. And back to Cogent. So yes, it does need some wood chips. We'll get on that here in a moment. Let's load up what little bit of drywall we have. Try to get this in the front trailer. Only 11,000. That's it, really. Okay, there we go. We'll call that good. And like I said, no Frito-Lay. I believe that one is Frito-Lay there. Yes, one right next to us we're going past is Frito-Lay. That one needs drywall only, I believe, and then it's all set. And then PepsiCo, I'll double check on this one. We'll just bring it over here because I know that one needed drywall as well. Don't think it needed anything else. Oh, it does need a little bit more steel. Okay, so we probably actually have that steel, I'm guessing. We'll have to double check. Oh, we're stuck on that trigger. Yeah, I actually need, looks like, quite a bit more drywall on this one. Okay, anytime it wants to unload. Oh, there it goes. And we gotta try to turn around in here. Someone put a cement mixer like right there. It makes it really hard to turn around. Whoa. Okay, we'll head back up to Cogent here. We'll drop off that small trailer. Don't think we need that anymore. That's just causing us troubles on the back. And again, as someone called it, Industrial Simulator here. Seems like a pretty good name for this map. There's so much non-farming related activities going on here. But it does make it fun. For those of you who have never played on this map, I highly, highly suggest you check out Pleasant Valley Rivers. And just my opinion, probably a little bit better playing at multiplayer just because the amount of things that are going around on this map. There's just so much stuff. I know I've heard a couple of people saying they've playing at single player. It's like, wow. I guess if you have course play, it probably won't be so bad. You can course play a lot of stuff, but you'd be course playing a lot of things. Like I said, there's just so much going on. Whoa. Truck is not liking this bridge, is it? So many things going on this map. It's just ridiculous. But it makes it fun, like I said. And we'll just check here. Like I said, I'm pretty sure we probably have enough steel, crystal steel here on the map somewhere. There we go, crystal steel. Oh, we got actually quite a bit of steel. It's out of ore at the moment, but we got quite a bit of steel there. So I think I only needed, what, 30,000 or so steel left to finish PepsiCo. Yeah, like I said, folks, we are getting close to probably wrapping up the map here. We're starting to fill up the fair. We got some stuff down there at the moment. Pretty much just waiting on probably Frito-Lay and PepsiCo to get built so we can actually start producing the items that those factories make. And yeah, like I said, drywall has been the major slowdown here. Anyway, we'll get on to doing some chipping here. And we'll just park the truck there for now, I guess. Well, looks like we got a little thing of cut wood. Which, by the way, I think was it Thomas, I like to say was the name. He said a good way to do this. The auto-loading trucks, which I don't see one around here at the moment. You can auto-load off the conveyor belts here. Just make sure you do not auto-load off where the pallet spawns. So, good pro tip there. You can auto-load off this conveyor belt here. It doesn't care if it gets auto-loaded off of. What matters, folks, do not load off of this. This will, it'll just say place is not free, even though it is gone. So just a bit of an annoying feature there. But just thought I'd share that with you folks. You can, there's an auto-loading trailer right there. You can auto-load off of it. Just make sure you don't auto-load off of the spot where the pallet actually spawns. And that goes for all the palletized locations. So it does make it a little bit easier there. Oh, we're not going to make that turn. Oh, we got the Kloss Xerion 4500. Very nice tractor, by the way. Yeah, let's see. Looks like someone's been cutting some wood here. Kind of the way I do it, I just pick a spot and start doing in a line here. So for those of you who've never used this wood chipper before, and I've had a few people on the server asking how to use this when they get on, fairly simple. Actually switch to it here. I don't know who chose the dolly trailer on the back, but I prefer a straight trailer myself without the dolly. Anyway, turn it on, drive up to the tree, make sure it's in the raised position. It should chip the whole tree. It did. And then lower it down and it should take out the stump. And for those of you who watched a few episodes back there, we were doing a little bit of chipping. I was having trouble with it taking out the stump. I think maybe because it was on a hill there. I think it was the hillside right there maybe we were doing it at. And it did not want to take down the stumps for some reason. And like I said before, folks, this is why I call this an overpowered chipper. It definitely makes that chipping way, way easier. Which, yeah, considering the amount that Cogent has been going through, it's probably a good thing. Doesn't seem like the wood chips at Cogent last very long. Okay, that does it for that line, I guess. We'll turn around and start heading back the other way. Also, doesn't seem like we got a whole lot of wood chips from that last couple of trees. Or is that just me, folks? I was not paying attention to the numbers that closely. See what's what happens here. Oh, it went up there. Okay. It did not go up there, though. Okay, so what is up with that? I've never had that issue before. But then again, I've never used this black trailer before, so I'm going to blame that, and we're going to get rid of this black trailer. Typically, I use those, I think, what are they called? Bergman trailers there. Those are the trailers I've always used. They got a fairly high capacity, and you don't have the dolly on the back that way. Makes it much easier to get around if you have to back up. Yeah, let's ditch this trailer somewhere. Oh, where shall we put it? Out of the way. Okay, make sure we disconnect the right thing here. Hey, that was the right one. The other one on the back, by the way, is the weights on the back here. So if you switch to the other item on the back, that's the weights. That's what those are. Okay, I'm going to take this trailer. Normally it takes about 6 trees to fill the trailer. We did not want to do that. There we go. Okay, we'll see if we can read a couple of comments here while we're chipping some trees, and hopefully this tipper works better. If not, maybe it's the tractor's fault then. Or maybe there's just something plain funny going on, I don't know. Tanner was saying keep the semi-livestock trailer. The Joskin just does not look American enough for Oklahoma. I don't know, if you ask me, the Joskin looks American enough if you ask me, but Yeah, we'll definitely be keeping the new livestock trailer we got on Oklahoma. And speaking of Joskin as well, I now have the updated one, which is supposed to hold horses as well. I haven't actually tried that yet. There we go. So far, so good. We got 2 out of 2. Zombie Killer was saying, do you know you can get Farming Simulator 16 on Windows 10? Yes, for those of you who did not know that, you can get Farming Simulator 16 on Windows 10 now. However, at the time I got Farming Simulator 16, you could not, so that's why I play it on my iPad. Yes, for those of you who have Windows 10, you can get Farming Simulator 16. Although, to be honest, if you're going to play Farming Simulator, I think you're better off just playing Farming Simulator 15 on your computer as opposed to Farming Simulator 16, but just my opinion. Oh, did not mean to get out there. Yeah, this definitely looks like it's working much better this time. I don't know if there's something with the other trailer there causing it to, like, miss the wood chips or what, but looks like we're getting them all this time, so that's much better. And one more tree here, and we should have this trailer full. Twisted Lids was saying, I used one combine on field 6, and it took a few days. Anyways, great video. Thank you very much for that. And yes, I bet if you used a combine on field, or one combine on field 6, I bet you it took you a while. For those of you who do not watch the Oklahoma series, field 6 is like a gigantic field on the Oklahoma map. Okay. Dump these here. The little down arrow there, by the way, is where you can dump the wood chips. Or you can dump them up at the top of the ramp as well. There's another, I don't know if you folks can see it, just at the top of the ramp there, there's another arrow. Oh, the tractor's like bouncing there a little bit. TLB84 Gaming was saying, great video. You should rent the combines for Field 6. That's actually a good idea. I not thought of that. If I don't have the money to buy the combines, like I said, we're going to hopefully get a couple more combines for Field 6 when we go to harvest the corn. If we don't have the money to buy them, we'll see if we can rent them. Let's see that. Oh, that took out the stump. Okay. And he was also suggesting once you get the field 6 harvested there, use the income from that to buy field 13. Can't buy a license. Oh, we don't even have a license, do we? Okay, doesn't actually technically matter when you're chipping trees. Probably to be safe, you should, but... yeah, it's not going to get the rest of that stump out, is it? Because we're on the hill, probably. Oh, maybe we should do that just a moment here. Yeah, we'll buy a license. That'll be good. Like I said, technically, you don't actually really need one for chipping trees. Just because of the way this chipper works, I guess. Jasper was saying, I'm from Holland. That's kind of interesting. Also, I should mention a big welcome to all the new subscribers. Been picking up quite a few subscribers the last couple of weeks. So a big welcome to all you folks. Oh, that really filled the trailer up. Okay. Not sure why so much more on that one than the other ones. Joseph was saying, speaking of a combine, you should get the John Deere S690i. That is probably what we'll do on Oklahoma there, folks. We'll probably get a couple of John Deere combines, assuming they have the same header width. That is going to be rather important, I think, to me. We're definitely going to want combines with the same header width. Which, actually, we have it on here. I can double-check that a minute. Is that the same header width? Depends which one you get, I guess. The 640, and I don't know if that's actually would be the proper size for that one, is not 13.7 meters. It's actually a little bit narrower. But I think this header actually is that wide. So I don't think that's actually... It should be actually a 645, not a 640. Anyway... We'll have to do some investigating on that. Caleb was saying, good video. Thank you very much for that. Tackle Junkie was asking, how do you buy beef and pigs? In Oklahoma, they are in the shop. Just go to the animals category. And you can buy beef and pigs from right there. Same horses are there as well. It's the same places you get sheep, horses, and chickens. Oh, I forgot to tell him I bought a license. Which, does it? Oh, it does show up down here now. Okay. Also, looks like someone accepted a contract for Port Dock 4 for sour cream chips. I'm guessing that's what those are. Yeah, 300,000 chips, folks. Oh, my goodness. I don't know who accepted that, but yeah, that's going to be a costly mistake right there. I know a lot of people think you have to cut down the trees with this chipper. You don't actually have to cut down the trees with this chipper. Like I said before, just drive up to the tree and it will, wait a couple seconds, it'll take it down. Oh, seems like some of these trees are getting just a little bit more wood chips from them. Must be some different trees in here or something. I'm used to, lately it's been about six trees, and it's been pretty consistent too. Six trees gets you about 96, 97% pull on the trailer. At least this trailer anyway. Andrew was saying, yeah, stick with Ford. I never buy a Dodge truck or one of those government motors vehicles. that's funny. I'm surprised I didn't get more comments from that comment I made in that video there. Samuel was asking, on the Mega Corn map, can you plant anything besides corn on that map? Here's the thing with that map, folks. There are no actual fields on that map. So if you're going to plant anything, you're first going to have to plow your fields. You're actually going to have to make some fields first. So what is currently planted on that map, until you plow a field and make a field, you cannot replant anything. So just a FYI about that. And that, by the way, is why on that map I cannot use course play to automatically detect combines, because there are actually no fields on that map. I know it shows, what does it show, one field or two fields or something like that. That is technically incorrect. There are no fields on that map. So you would have to get a plow, do some plowing, and actually, you know, make the field before you could actually plant anything. Anyway, folks, looking at the timer, it looks like it's already time to wrap up the episode. Wow, seems like it went fast. So anyway, with that, folks, if you folks have any comments or questions, be sure to leave them below. And yes, that tree definitely made more than the rest of the trees have. I just happened to notice that. Anyway, folks, like I said, we're going to wrap it up. So thanks for watching, and till next time.